We are racing around, packing up, and otherwise going crazy as we prep for E3 2019. But hey, companies are still putting out new press releases and new announcements, so we couldn't do them dirty, and we got to bring you the new Switch games of the week one more time before we enter the E3 zone.
Yeah, Zach, it's very, very busy time of the year here for us. You guys have seen a ton of videos. You're going to see a ton more. I'm bummed that we're going to go on a brief hiatus after this.
Yes. We'll be back in 2 weeks with another new games and also the giveaway stuff. We're just really rushing around right now. So we will resume that when we come back. But there are 7 new games. 5.5 of them are brand new announcements. And 1.5 are release date updates. So let's get the release date update, the true release date update, out the way right off the bat. My friend Pedro, coming from Devolver Digital and a Banana Man, is released on June 20th. Now, this is interesting because we hypothesized that perhaps this was going to be one of the E3 day and date drops. Well, it's not, Gabe, because it's coming out on June 20th for $20.
Still a good release date. We can play this on the way back home to from E3, right? Sort of.
If we get review code.
We'll see.
It has a 15% pre-order discount right now if you want to get $1.50 off that. It is a very fast and furious combat game. Well, I guess it's slow, because you slow down time as you move. I don't know. It's fast and slow, but it is all about doing delicious moves and tricks as you strategically and symphonically eliminate your foes. I played it back at PAX East. I felt like it needed a little more polish and performance, a little one over, but maybe that's happened, and maybe come June 20th, this will be another Devolver hit.
We've had a couple other instances of you thinking that, where like, hey, you're like, this game needs a little bit of polish, and then it ends up happening. So yes. I'm very hopeful that that's going to be the case here with this one, and I'm hopeful that it's going to be a smashing good time on Nintendo Switch.
I hope so. I hope it does. I hope it is. I also hope that SpongeBob SquarePants comes to Switch, and hey, he is, because SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom Rehydrated is coming to Nintendo Switch in 2020. I did not know, Gabe, that this game had like a true cult following of some sort.
I didn't know that either, but man, people are into it. It's also like cheap. It's not like a full like retail experience, so that's a good thing. I believe it is $30. I'll confirm that here, Zach, but How did you ever play this?
I did play this. I was a massive SpongeBob fan back in the day. I even brought in one of the season one episodes to my creative writing class in middle school, or it would have been elementary school. I think it was like fifth grade.
Oh.
And convinced my teacher to show the Rock Bottom episode in class as a beautiful expose of creativity. The graphics look really nice, to be honest. They look really pretty. It's like Link's Awakening got all dolled up, and now SpongeBob got all dolled up. I don't think that this game will hold up gameplay-wise, because it is from an era where character platformers were not that great. But just kind of like a bring it back thing is cool. And Gabe, there is a brand new horde mode for 2 players online and split screen.
Yeah, they're saying that there's extra stuff in this game that was like cut out originally, and I have confirmed it is in fact $30, so a good discounted price.
Yes.
I'm happy with that. I might give it a go. I remember playing it a little bit, but I was ever really super into SpongeBob, if I'm being honest. I don't know. Maybe it'll be fun.
I love that for system requirements, at least on Steam, they have I'm ready listed for everything. OS, processor, graphics, sound card.
Yeah.
Obviously, we'll be ready for it on Switch when it hits sometime next year. Really, kind of a good week for announcements, because Darksiders Genesis leaked and then was confirmed at the Stadia conference, but it is coming to Switch. It is a Diablo-style spin-off of the Darksiders franchise. It looks pretty cool. I don't know if this is being targeted as like a full-price thing, an eShop thing. I'm not quite sure, but it looks neat.
If I had to guess, I think it's going to be full price, and I think that this is going to be very Diablo-esque. And we get the fourth Horseman. We always wanted co-op in Darksiders. This isn't quite what we meant when we were all thinking and talking about that. But yeah, this could honestly be really, really cool. If they have some awesome RPG elements, if they get a bunch of loot in there, that's going to be great. We'll see how it all shapes out. But this is surprising. I didn't expect a new Darksiders game just because Darksiders 3 is still fairly new. You know.
Right.
So we'll see how anything in that kind of a game shapes up for, you know, a potential Darksiders 4, but for now I think this is going to be a cool little side distraction for fans of the franchise.
Well, I've got some breaking information for you. There's an Amazon page which shows box art indicating physical retail release, and it's $40. So this is going to be a mid-tier price point for Darksiders Genesis. It's War and Strife, and it seems like it could be very cool. As you mentioned, Darksiders 3 didn't do it for me. I love Darksiders 1 and 2. You love the War Master port on Switch, and it seems like the definitive port is coming at some point. Will they channel the charm again? I know some people like 3, but it felt very budget to me.
Yeah, I mean, they've done a bunch of updates to 3. I haven't gone back and played it or anything, but they have made it a little more traditional.
To be clear.
Yeah, so, I mean, we'll see. It's still a big game coming to Switch. That's cool, so I'm with it.
And even though it's not 4, it is your first chance to play as Strife. So, yeah. It's bringing the fourth horseman in, even if it's not the fourth game. I love Diablo 3 on Switch, so if this can be similar quality, I mean, that's probably asking a lot, but even close, like, I'm down. I'll check it out. I'll play.
Same.
All right. Grandia HD Collection is coming soon to Nintendo Switcheroo. So it previously was known as the Grandia plus Grandia 2 HD Remaster. Now it's upgraded to be the Grandia HD Collection. And they say that it's coming soon to Switch. More info at E3.
I played the original Grandia back in the day. PlayStation was my jam for all these JRPGs. I remember it being a fun game. I can't lie and say I have like incredibly fond memories of it, but I do remember getting through it, and just because back then literally any JRPG I could get my hands on I wanted. JRPGs are good on Switch. There's a bunch of them, and hey, it's good to see the library continue to grow with some classics.
Yeah, I don't have much to say. I didn't play these games. Gabe is my JRPG master, both behind the scenes and in front of the scenes. You know that we've got a bunch of Final Fantasy, Star Ocean is coming back, now Grandia. So if you're into that, get into it. Now, this is the half announcement, half release thing. Merge Games is putting out Dead Cells Action Game of the Year Edition, which includes the recently released Rise of the Giant DLC. I love that this is not the Game of the Year Edition, because it did not win a Game of the Year. So it is the Action Game of the Year Edition, which I think is just so cheeky. It's coming August 20th to the States, August 23rd to the EU. It's going to be physical. It comes with a reversible cover, a key ring, an updated art booklet, and obviously that Rise of the Giant DLC.
This is a really good package, and people that love physical, I'm sure they've been waiting on this one, because this is like one of those like amazing, amazing games. I don't know why it didn't win Game of the Year. It kind of deserves it. It's an awesome game. I love it.
Yes, and they have confirmed that you will need to download the DLC.
Which is
fine. It's just, it's kind of the way things go. But yeah, maybe they just didn't want to remake. I don't know. You download it. We'll leave it at that. It's a great game, though. It's fantastic. It's not my favorite roguelite on the platform, but it's very good, and it's a lot of people's favorite. So you can't go wrong with the Action Game of the Year Edition. All right. A big franchise that some people know called Destiny just went free-to-play, but Switch is getting a free-to-play of its own. Asphalt 9 Legends is coming to Switch this summer. The popular mobile racing game with many titles is making its way to Switch. It has local split screen multiplayer, a brand new quick race mode for offline and online 8-player action. You can use Joy-Con, Pro Controller, Gyro, touchscreen, and innovative touch drive controls. Ooh. To maneuver your cars through the roads of Asphalt 9.
Have you ever played an Asphalt game?
I have not. I'm not the biggest fan of mobile titles anymore. The only thing that makes this notable to me is it's a big series. They're not trying to charge you for it, and it adds another free-to-play game to the Switch.
Yeah, there you go. That free-to-play library continues to grow. Like you, I am not a fan of mobile games anymore, and whatever. Who cares about Destiny free-to-play when we have Asphalt?
Absolutely. All right, last game looks pretty interesting, Gabe. This one's kind of out of left field, but I want to go to that field. It's called Neon Junctions. It's from Radaleika Games and Nine Eyes Game Studio. It's a puzzle platformer with a heavy 80s vibe. So we're talking art, synthwave soundtrack, And you're in cyberspace trying to deal with 34 levels of puzzle action. It's not out anywhere yet, or maybe it just came out on Steam, but it's coming to Switch tomorrow, June 7th, for $5.
Do you remember when the internet was called like cyberspace? Did you ever use that terminology like back in like the aughts? Like, ooh.
Maybe not for the internet, but I definitely heard / used it for just like that concept in general.
I'll see you on cyberspace tonight when we talk about AIM.
Gosh.
Yeah. For anybody that doesn't know what AIM is, it's AOL Instant Messenger. It's a long dead form of communication.
AOL Instant Messenger.
Yeah.
Great way for high school boys and girls to flirt via text.
And do mad other stuff through text. All right. The game looks cool.
Let's not go there. Yeah. It could be cool. It could not be. It's kind of tough to tell. It says you'll need to capture and move conductive cubes, close electrical circuits, restore power. So it's much more of a like sleepy functional puzzle game, I guess.
Yeah.
Gabe, I'm just this E3 prep is draining. I'm not slight to Neon Junctions. It actually looks kind of cool, and for $5, like it only needs to be kind of cool.
Yeah. I'll see you on cyberspace, Zach.
Okay. Well, before we do that, let's recap what we got here. My pick of the week.
I have an easy
fool
one.
Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. But I'll risk that shame and go with Darksiders Genesis. If it can channel what I like about Darksiders 1 and 2, if Strife is cool, and it can bring in some Diablo ARPG action with some new like twists and turns that they bring, THQ Nordic and co. bring to the table, and at $40, it kind of fits a neat slot.
Yeah, that's what I was going to pick. Easy. I low-key kind of love the Darksiders series. Sans 3. 3, again, just didn't do it for us. But other than that, they're 2 for 3, right? Maybe they'll be 3 for 4. We'll see.
Yeah, I mean, 75% is pretty good. It's not going to do much for you in school, but it sure will make you a phenomenal athlete. That's the list. Let us know in the comments down below which game you're most pumped for. I mean, Pedro is also pretty cool, and SpongeBob coming back is neato as well. So let us know which one you're excited for in those comments down below. We're taking next week off, so we'll see you with Thursday games in 2 weeks. We will have new games next week, but they will be of a bigger and better caliber than we're used to discussing. So that will be exciting. Gabe, next time we're back, we're going to be on the other side. It's either going to be sad disappointment or massive enthusiasm.
Isn't there an Adele song about this?
Yeah, I'm sure there is.
Okay.
Maybe it's Frozen. Maybe it's Adele. It's something.
Who knows?
Who knows? But
if
we know. We'll be
if
back
it's
soon.
Not Wu-Tang, I'm not really like familiar with it.
Yeah, exactly. Until next time, everybody. Thanks so much for watching. Thanks so much for being here. Hit that like button. Enjoyed the video and are pumped for any of these games or E3. And for myself and Gabe, Switch Force out.